My name's Paul Provost. I'm a structural engineer for the New York State Thruway Authority. I've been there for about 26 years. And right now I'm the director of bridge inspection and load rating. We're on the thruway system right now, so it's 650 miles. We own and operate over 800 bridges. And right now we're at the site of two of our mainline bridges. They're twin structures, which are fairly typical on the thruway. This was one of the first three bridges that was reconstructed in 1994, where we changed out the epoxy with galvanized reinforcing steel during construction by order on contract. The reason that we were looking at galvanized reinforcement were its advantages over epoxy. A galvanized coating is a mechanical coating, so it bonds to the rebar. It's a more durable coating. Zinc is a metal that does not expand when it deteriorates. The major cause of deterioration of any reinforced concrete is when water, especially salt-laden water, gets into the concrete, starts to corrode the bars expand, and then deteriorate the concrete. With galvanized rebar, that is not the case. Lifespan of galvanized reinforced concrete is much higher than it is for epoxy, and the costs are almost identical in all the research we've done, and we've been doing this now for 23 years. Beginning in 1996, all of our projects, whether they were bridge replacements, new bridges, rehabilitations, substructure repairs, highway barriers, anything with reinforced concrete, all the reinforced concrete has been galvanized. So far with all of the bridges that we have used galvanized rebar, we have not had to do any maintenance related to those items or to the galvanized rebar. It's held up very well, and we have shown no signs of deterioration of concrete where we've used galvanized rebar. So that's a huge advantage for us. To date, we've used 30 million pounds of galvanized rebar since 1993. On the new twin TZ bridges that are currently under construction, we're using an additional 60 million pounds of galvanized rebar. The goal of what we're trying to do is eliminate maintenance in the future, or at least reduce it as much as we can, and to put work out there that is going to last as long as possible. And in the case of a new bridge, we want these bridges to last between 75 and 100 years.